Hello, my darlings. We are doing baking live via tutorial. Wally's running around. It's a lot of fun over here in the darling household. Today we're going to make lemon macarons, and not just any lemon macarons, but with a little bit of booze. So you'll see what I'm talking about at the very end, but let's get started. Let me go grab a mixing bowl. First step is actually measuring out 1¼ cups of finely ground almond flour. So we have that ready, and now we're gonna add equal parts of confectioner's sugar. So 1¼ cups of powdered sugar to our almond flour. Go ahead and sift your mixture together twice. This will make sure it's nice and put together and no lumps in your batter. Now I'm gonna snap my fingers and my KitchenAid is going to appear right here. Voila, it's here. So now we're gonna set aside our mixing bowl of almond flour and powdered sugar. And in the KitchenAid, I have put 3 egg whites, and we are going to make a beautiful meringue. So we're gonna pop this on high. We're gonna watch our ears because it's going to be loud. Here we go. Blending away, go ahead and add 1/3 a cup of granulated sugar to your egg whites. Just slowly sprinkle it in. And then add a teaspoon of vanilla. This is literally the largest bottle of vanilla you'll probably ever see. From Mexico, it's the best. The meringue is perfect. We're gonna add a little bit of yellow food coloring to this and keep blending because I want to make a pretty lemon color. All right, here we go. Cover your ears. Voila, look how pretty this is. This is a beautiful meringue. And look at the pretty color, yellow. It's gonna be gorgeous. I made it a light color and I'm even gonna use some edible markers later on. We have our meringue, yellow meringue, macaroon shell ready to go. So what we're gonna do is actually add our dry mix into our meringue. What we're gonna do is stir it until we make ribbons. You don't wanna overstir. Macaroons can be really intimidating, so I highly suggest making them a few times to get the right practice in. The batter is perfect, it's nice and smooth, and it's making beautiful, beautiful ribbons off our spoon. You don't want to overstir, or otherwise your macarons will collapse. So this is perfect. Keep it just like this. I'm gonna grab a couple baking mats right behind me, and we're gonna start piping. We are ready to do some piping. This is a reusable piping tool. You can use a piping bag with a medium-sized round tip. This is a nice size, usually a half inch works really nicely. So we're going to make just round dots and slide away once you have the size that you'd like. You can make macaroons any size that you would like, but this is looking just the way that I want, and you want to evenly space them out because you're going to tap them out as well. Another note is that my flavorings I put on the inside, so your lemon flavor is actually gonna be coming through in the filling. All right, once our macarons are piped, we're just going to tap them out till they're nice and smooth. And these are looking beautiful. If you've never seen a macaron, they're always gorgeous. In the Parisian windows of the patisseries, they're so smooth and gorgeous. These are going to be lemon. And this recipe that I'm teaching you makes 25 macaroons. We're gonna let our macaroons dry for about 30 minutes and we're going to bake them. Okay, our macaroons are ready to bake. You're going to bake these at 280 degrees Fahrenheit for 15 minutes on a baking tray. Do open up the oven door just to let steam out here and there, and that helps the macaroons not get too hot. While the macaroons are drying, I whipped up some lemon vanilla buttercream. So the best way to make buttercream is to Google just a basic buttercream recipe. My recipe is 1 stick of softened butter, 2 cups of powdered sugar, a teaspoon of vanilla, and then I also use pure lemon paste. This is an amazing brand right here. This is Nielsen Massey. And of course, last but not least, heavy cream. Blend that all together until it's stiff and you have delicious buttercream to fill your macarons. Macarons out of the oven. They look perfect. I'm so happy about these. We're gonna grab a shell and we are going to actually draw a lemon shape on our macaron shell. These are edible markers and you can actually, however you want to decorate them, but I want the illusion of a lemon. So we're gonna make beautiful triangles in the center to give it some definition. It should look something like this at the end. We have finished decorating our macarons. So look how cute these are. So I've actually drawn a lemon shape. You can use this with a yellow edible marker. So cute. I'm gonna do this to all of them. I'm gonna fill our macarons. This is the best part. We're getting to the final countdown here. So you can put a little bit of filling in. This is about good right here. You don't wanna get too much filling. And just go ahead and pop the top of the macaron on and it is ready to go. We're gonna fill all of them right now. Do the best part. This is magnificent. We are actually going to infuse our macarons with Kettle One vodka. Yes, that's what I said. So what I'm gonna do is actually pour a little bit into a glass, just like this. One of the best flavors ever together is lemon and sugar. I love a lemon drop, so this is going to be fantastic. So now we're gonna grab one of our syringes. They look very medical, but they are for a cupcake, I promise. We are going to just grab in our glass some of our beautiful vodka. We love Kettle One. And we are going to infuse our macarons just like so. Aren't these the cutest things you've ever seen? Lemon sugar, little sweet, little bite of something naughty, little alcohol. I am super excited. I'm gonna stack these up on this plate and show you the finished product. These are literally the cutest thing I have ever seen. So yes, our very boozy lemon sugar macaroons. Go and have a bite. Oh, little shot of vodka. Voila. Oh, that is my kind of dessert. See you next time, baking live.